cyclic electron transport and cyclic photophosporilation. This is the cyclic electron transport. Here the PS1 only involved. In the PS1, the active center, the reaction center is P700. Here the chlorophyll A are present. The antenna pigments are absorb the light and reach and given to the P700. There the P700 is get excited by getting the photon molecules. Here when it get excited, here two electrons are released. The released electrons are circulated within the photosystem. It means they are again come back and reach the P700 reaction center. Hence the electrons are circulated inside only PS1 only. That's why it is called cyclic electron transport. Here no water molecule is cleaved, no oxygen molecule is released, no NADPH2 are formed, only ATP is formed. How means, you see here, first the light, the solar energy, the radiant energy is absorbed by the pigments present on antenna. So they pass the light to the P700 reaction center. While getting the radiant energy by P700, it get excited. Here it release the two electrons. The released two electrons are here, it is excited. The released two electrons are absorbed by first pyridoxine. Pyridoxine is the pigment. It is a colorless pigment. Why it is colorless means it analogous to the chlorophyll structure, but in the chlorophyll structure at center Mg plus ions are present. Instead of Mg plus ions, hydrogen ions are present, that leads to colorless. So it means the pyridoxine is consist inside of pyrrol rings. It means between the among the pyrrol rings, the center reaction, the center metal, that is Mg plus 2. Instead of the Mg plus 2, H plus ions are present. That's why it's become colorless. So the pyridoxine is considered as a colorless pigment. So first two electrons are absorbed by the pyridoxine. So this is the one of the electron carrier, and the electrons are passed to cytochrome B, B6, and then to cytochrome F. Between these two, the plastoquinone cycle is being carried. So the plastoquinone cycle means here is the reduction and oxidation reactions are taken. So the two electrons are passed from pyridoxine to cytochrome B6, cytochrome B6 to cytochrome F, cytochrome F to finally they reach to the plastocyanin. So oxidation reduction. You see here, by losing of two electrons, P700 get oxidized. Again it get reduction. It take again the two electrons from plastocyanin. By taking of two electrons, it get reduced. So you see here the electron transportation is circular manner. So that's why it is called cyclic electron transport. Every two electron transportation, there is a proton accumulation also, proton translocation also. So every one electron, two photons are translocated. Here two electrons are transmitted, that's why here four photons are translocated in lumen thylakoid. Thylakoid lumen. According to chemiosmotic theory, for three protons can able to produce one ATP. So here, from here, one ATP is released. So this is about the cyclic electron transport.